Ibn al-Qayyim rahmatullahi mentions the riwayat, the lowest jannati, the lowest jannati. Allah will say to that person, tamanna, desire, ask for what you want. If it is told to an ordinary person, then ask for whatever you want and whatever you ask for will be given to you. I'm giving you 1 minute. In 1 minute, how much he can ask for? How long does it take to say, I want 10 homes? Or I want 10 palaces? Or I want 10 billion rand? Takes a few seconds. Allah will say to the lowest jannati, ask. He will not be given 1 minute. He will be given 3 days and 3 nights to ask. The lowest jannati, he will ask and ask and ask and ask and ask, and Allah will grant and grant and grant and grant. And finally Allah Ta'ala will say to him, قَدْ رَضِيتُ بِدُونِ مَا يَحِقُّ لَكَ. You have become satisfied with less than that which I wanted to give you. Whatever you have asked for is yours, and 10 times that is yours. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentions a riwayat about the lowest jannati. Lengthy riwayat, just one section of it. فَتَقَدَّمْ حَتَّى يُفْتَحَ لَهُ الْقَصْرِ. He will go ahead in his jannat until he will come to a huge palace. وَهُوَ مِن دُرَّةٍ مُجَوَّفَ سَقَائِفُهَا وَأَبْوَابُهَا وَأَغْلَاقُهَا وَمَفَاتِيحُهَا مِنْهَا. This palace will be a dome of pearl. The doors, the walls, the floors, the roof, everything of it will be out of pure gold. تَسْتَقْبِلُهُ جَوْهَرَةٌ خَضْرَى مُبْطِنَةٌ بِحَمْرَى فِيهَا سَبْعُونَ بَابٌ كُلُّ بَابٍ يُفْضِي إِلَى جَوْهَرَةٍ خَضْرَى مُبْطِنَةٌ كُلُّ جَوْهَرَةٍ تُفْضِي إِلَى جَوْهَرَةٍ عَلَى غَيْرِ لَوْنِ الْأُخْرَى فِي كُلِّ جَوْهَرَةٍ سُرُرٌ وأزواج ووصائف أدناهن حوراء عينا. In front of this palace will be a huge green dome, actually a green pearl. It will be lined on the inside with red. This pearl will lead to 70 doors. Each door will lead to another huge pearl. The lining of each of these different pearls will be of different colors. In each of these pearls will be beds, will be wives, will be servants, will be the maidens of Jannat. The lowest of them will be a beautiful maiden, the lowest will be a beautiful maiden with huge round black eyes. She will be wearing 70 different garments, 70 different colors. Each garment, different color, different texture, different smell. But the texture of all 70 garments are such that he will see his reflection on her chest through the 70 garments. And the weight of the 70 garments will be such that he will be able to lift all 70 garments on the joint of his smallest finger. And her beauty will be such, Jannat gets better and better and better. Dunya gets worse and worse and worse. Dunya is going towards ruination. Dunya is going towards destruction. Jannat is better and better and better. The Jannati will be sitting in his palace. There will be a knock at the door. His servant will open the door. The angel of Allah will be there, asking permission to enter the court of the Jannati. وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ ثَمَّ رَأَيْتَ نَعِيمًا وَمُلْكًا كَبِيرًا. Allah says, when you see my Jannat, when you see my Jannat, you will see bounties and a vast kingdom. Mufassirin explain in the tafsir of Mulkan Kabira that Allah will make this Jannati a great king. One of the tafsirs of this is such a great ruler that the angels will have to seek permission to enter his court. This servant will whisper to the next servant, why? Is the court of the king. Respect has to be observed. Reverence has to be observed. Each one will whisper, till the last servant will whisper in the ears of this Jannati, one angel of Allah wants permission to enter. He will whisper back, give him permission. The chain will continue to the last servant till the angel enters. This angel will be carrying a fruit wrapped up in silk, will bring it to the Jannati and will say to the Jannati that this is a special gift which Allah has sent for you. The silk will be removed. He will see this beautiful fruit. Then the Jannati will say that this fruit, I already have it in my gardens. Kullama ruziqu minha min thamaratir rizqa qalu hadha alladhi ruziqna min qabl. He will say that we were given this fruit before. I already have it in my gardens. So many different types of fruit. Maybe, example, he has 10,000 different types of fruit in his gardens. He says this, وَأُتُوا بِهِ مُتَشَابِهَا. It will be outwardly resembling, but the inside is not the same. The angel will say, why don't you try this one? Try this one. He will take one bite. If the Jannati had 10,000 different fruits in his garden, Allah Ta'ala has kept the taste of all 10,000 different fruits in this one fruit. If there are 5 different tastes and you join it together, it will become a 6th taste. That is not what will happen. There's no kamal or achievement in that. But he will take the bite and like a person scrolling through a book, instantly his mouth will register individually each taste of 10,000 different fruits in the one bite. وَأُتُوا بِهِ مُتَشَابِهَا. They will be given ni'mats and bounties that will outwardly resemble, but it will get better and better. Abdullah bin Mubarak rahmatullahi alayhi says, when the Jannati enters into Jannat, he will immediately be overtaken by a burst of joy when he sees Jannat. It will be said to him, أَرَأَيْتَ سُوَارَ فَرْحَتِكَ هَذِهِ. Are you experiencing a burst of joy? He will say, yes. It will be said to him that from now till eternity, your joy will increase. Your joy will increase. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu mentions, إِنَّ فِي الْجَنَّةِ نَهْرًا إِسْمُهُ بَيْدَخْ عَلَيْهِ قُبَابٌ مِّنْ يَاقُوتٍ تَحْتَهُ جُوَارُ النَّابِتَاتِ. He says, in Jannat is one stream, one river. Its name is Baydakh. Over it is a dome of sapphire. Underneath this dome are beautiful maidens of Jannat, Nabitat. Like how vegetation grows up, these beautiful maidens have grown up. يَقُولُ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ. The people of Jannat, the men of Jannat will say, انطلقوا بنا إلى البيدخ. Let's take a stroll and go to Baydakh. As they will arrive at Baydakh, they will start analyzing, like judges of a Miss Universe competition, all the streams of beautiful women that are there on display. إِذَا أَعْجَبَ رَجُلٌ مِّنْهُمْ بِإِمْرَأَةٍ. If he finds one that interests him, all he will do, مَسَّ مِعْصَمُهَا فَتَبِعَتْهُ وَتَنْبُتُ فِي مَكَانِهَا أُخْرَى. He will touch her forearm, she will come to life and follow him, and in her place another one will grow up. To continue the riwayat of Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, on the lowest Jannati, he says that such will be the beauty of that woman, كُلَّمَا أَعْرَضَ عَنْهَا إِعْرَاضَةً إِزْدَادَتْ فِي عَيْنِهِ سَبْعِينَ ضِعْفًا. Every time the Jannati turns his face away from his wife and he looks back, when he looks back, she will have become 70 times more beautiful. When he turns away, his kingdom is such, he is a king, she will not turn away from him. In one riwayat it comes, in aqbalat or adbarat wahiya muqbila. Whether she is walking towards him or walking away from him, her face will still face him. When he turns away and looks back, he will find that she is 70 times more beautiful. فَتَقُولُ لَهَا فَيَقُولُ لَهَا. He will say to her, وَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ إِزْدَدْتَ فِي عَيْنِي سَبْعِينَ ضِعْفًا عَمَّا كَانَتْ قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ. He will say to her, Allah's qasam, What has happened? You have become 70 times more beautiful than what you were before. She will say to him, فَتَقُولُ لَهُ وَاللَّهِ وَاللَّهِ وَأَنْتَ لَقَدْ إِزْدَدْتَ فِي عَيْنِي سَبْعِينَ ضِعْفًا. Allah's Qasam, and again Allah's Qasam, you have become 70 times more beautiful in my eyes. When Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu hears this, he addresses Ka'b radiallahu ta'ala anhu, أَلَا تَسْمَعُ إِلَى مَا يُحَدِّثُنَا ابن أم عبد عن أدنى أهل الجنة منزلا فكيف علاهم. He says to Ka'b that can't you hear, listen to what Ibn Mas'ud is saying about the lowest Jannati. What must be the highest one? What must be the highest one? There are stages in Jannat. Ka'b radiallahu ta'ala anhu replies, فيها ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت إن الله تعالى خلق دارا في الجنة جعل فيها ما شاء من الأزواج والأشربة والثمرات ثم أطبقها. He says there are such things which no eye has seen, no ear has ever heard of. Allah Ta'ala has made a special palace in Jannat, referring to Jannatul Firdaus, the highest Jannat. Allah has made a special palace in Jannat. In it, Allah has kept wives, and Allah has kept palaces, and Allah has kept fruit, and Allah has kept bounties. Then Allah sealed him. Allah sealed that Jannat. فَلَمْ يَرَهَا أَحَدْ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ لَا جِبْرِيلِ وَلَا غَيْرُهُ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. And this is such a special surprise, the highest Jannat, that no creation of Allah, not even the Malaika, not even Jibreel has seen this Jannat. Allah has created us for that. Allah has not sent us for the worthless and the useless things of this world.